Fire Emblem Three Houses. What a journey that was. If you're still thinking about buying the game, then stay until the end, as I'm going to break down the game to the best of my ability. So, let's get to why Fire Emblem Three Houses made such an impression to me. If you enjoyed the video, like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. First thing I want to talk about is the story. The game takes place on the continent of Fódlan. The landmass is divided into three rival nations who are now at peace: the Adresian Empire to the southwest, the Holy Kingdom of Fergus to the north, and the Lyster Alliance to the east. At the center of the continent is the Garreg Mach Monastery, a neutral territory home to both Church of Seirus and the Officers Academy. This is also where the bulk of the story takes place. You play as Byleth, a mercenary who together with his dad Geralt live their life doing jobs and spend their life fighting. After they save three students from bandits, it is revealed that these three are the future leaders of the three nations of Fódlan. Because you save them, they are greatly impressed by you, and because Geralt is revealed to be the former captain of the Holy Knights, you are heading together into the monastery where the Church's Archbishop Rhea waits for you. There you are given an important choice that will determine how the story is going to progress, and that is to choose your house. You can choose from the Blue Lions, the Black Eagles and the Golden Deers. Each house has its own students and leaders, so you should choose depending on what characters you like the most. It's important to note that to completely see the whole story and understand every character's motivations, you will have to play the game at least 3 times, and considering that one playthrough took me 56 hours, you're going to be busy for a while. So that is the setting of the story. You can expect a lot of politics and war stories while playing, but also a lot of interactions between the characters, as every house will have different cutscenes depending on what characters you have into your team. And that's what I really liked about the story. It really made me care about the characters, my students, and to bond with them. Almost every one of them is very well written, with different backstories that you can discover while playing. It's rare for a game to do that, so it's definitely one of the better points of the game. I'm not going to talk about the story more because I don't want to spoil you, and it's better to go into it without knowing too much. One last thing I will tell you is that there are a lot of surprising twists. Now, let's move on into the gameplay. The game is structured in two sections: the life at the church and the battlefield. The game has a calendar system that lets you choose the activities you're going to do until the end of the month. When you finally get at the end, the story will progress and you will fight the battle regarding the story. So, you will have a whole month to prepare. Think it like Persona 5, it's really similar. At the weekends you have a free day, so you can explore the monastery, get to know your students better, and deepen your relationship with them. Train Byleth to increase his stats, do quests, buy items, and even fish. The social elements are great. Getting to know the students was really interesting because every one of them has a very unique personality, and I wanted to get to know all of them. But unfortunately, you can't do that one playthrough because of the time constraints of the game. But if you like other characters from other houses, you can recruit them into your own house if you choose to. So, choose wisely. Another nice feature the game has is support levels. Every character, including Byleth, will get close with each other through interacting and battling together, and when that happens, a little cutscene will unlock showing the different relationships slowly getting better as they get to know each other. What's mind-blowing is that there are so many different combinations of these cutscenes, depending on what students you have into your house, and it also takes account of the students you recruited. That makes the game really enjoyable even if you replay it. If you choose to not socialize, you can either battle for experience and items or do a seminar to increase your and your student skills. There's also an option to rest, but I didn't really find this useful. By the end of the week, you get to instruct your students and choose what skills you want them to focus in. That's really important because you will want to have a plan for what class they are going to end up by training the right skills. If you're wondering about classes for your house, I have made videos for every house regarding that, so check them out if you have a better time. Every character starts from either commoner or noble and ends up to a masterclass of your choice. There's also a good variety of classes for every situation, and different suitors are more fitted for different classes, so again, make sure to have a plan. You can also just make every character the default class that the game pushes you, though if you want, with no problems if you don't like to plan out your classes. So don't worry about that. So, what's the combat like? Just like its predecessors, Three Houses has a tactical combat that will have you choosing your units and controlling every one of them in a big map. it's like a game of chess. You can move around your units in a specific distance and attack the enemy units when you are in range. Every character has a unique attack and abilities. You can use weapons like bows, lances, swords, gauntlets, axes, and even magic. I really enjoy the combat and I can even say that it's pretty addicting. Units can be equipped with different abilities and combat arts, and also with battalions, which are essentially a group of support units that can perform a unique attack depending on their type. It's really addicting building up your units slowly and seeing them destroy their enemies after some time. It's really important to know that if you set your game in classic mode, then if a unit dies, it's gone forever. Permadeath has been a long staple in the Fire Emblem and it's back at 3 houses too. If you don't want to go through the agony of losing your favorite characters, then set the game in casual mode, no pressure. To complete most missions, you will have to either kill the enemy commander or kill every enemy. Personally, I would like to see some different objectives to spice things up. That's one of my few complaints about the game. Also, the difficulty is kinda all over the place, from really easy missions to frustrating ones in some parts of the game. Generally though, the game is on the easy side. The best experience I had with combat is when I fought demonic beasts, because they required a different approach in order to defeat them, and they also gave you nice rewards for killing them. Last thing to talk about is graphics and sound. The game has an anime cel-shaded look, and that's really fitting for it. The character models are well made and detailed, with a lot of different idle animations. The environments though look really flat out bad sometimes and really bland, especially while wandering the monastery sometimes. The textures are of an average quality and lighting and shadows tend to be on the low side. To tell you the truth, I didn't mind the graphics that much. To me they looked just okay and the game was that good that I didn't care anyway. Now, about sound, the voice acting is excellent all around the board for both Japanese and English. And it's also really important to note that every line in the game is voice acted. It's a really nice detail in my opinion. Battle sounds from slashes to punches and magic explosions sound great and make you feel the impact of your attacks. The soundtrack is phenomenal, with relaxing tunes while wandering the monastery and intense epic tracks while battling. The music is on point throughout the game. So my score for Fire Emblem 3 Houses is a 9 out of 10. An absolutely fantastic journey with many thrills and excitement that is only slightly hindered by some lack in variety and combat. If you enjoyed the video, hit like, subscribe for more videos like this. Also give me some feedback in the comments about what videos you want to see from me and what I can improve on. Thanks for watching, until the next time, have a fantastic day.